that typically they have the names written down. So they have all the, how they contact in case they get an injury. I can guarantee you, there is not one board in the NFL that has Colin Kaepernick's name on there as a potential free agent. And the reason is, and they don't have to admit it, it's because of his stance for the protest and the recent grievance that he filed against the NFL.
...2016 was an interesting year for sports. The Chicago Cubs would win their first World Series since 1908, ending the longest championship drought in American sports. The Cavs would bring home the first NBA title for the city of Cleveland, and one of the most prolific comeback wins in the history of basketball. And the world would mourn the loss of the greatest, Muhammad Ali. And in August, during a preseason game, cameras would catch 49ers quarterback Colin Kaepernick refusing to stand during the playing of the national anthem. He would cite racial inequality and police brutality as his reason, causing a chain of events that would forever change America's favorite sport. It was a preseason game, and even the biggest NFL fan isn't sitting watching every single preseason game, and those who aren't fans of football probably didn't even know this happened, so why was it such a big deal? The singing of the anthem became a staple of sports ceremonies during World War II, as a way to invoke patriotism in the hearts of thousands of fans that filled the stadiums. And in the early 90s, as troops fought in the Persian Gulf, sports was yet again used to solicit patriotism. And with cable TV and syndicated sports networks, capturing now millions of viewers at the stadium or in the living room, the national anthem pregame was now a spectacle. Our favorite celebrities would take center stage to wail out their rendition of the Star Spangled Banner. But after the tragic events of 9/11, the NFL suspended all of its games for what would have been week 2 of the 2001 season. And when it began again the following week, there were large flags donning the field, B-52 bombers flying atop the stadium, 9/11 memorabilia, celebrities, NYPD and FDNY servicemen, reminding us to support our brave troops as America is now under attack. Players and coaches would otherwise stay in the locker room during the pregame show, as they did the halftime celebrations. But now, for the first time, amid chants of USA, NFL players would be seen on the sideline, hand over heart, during the singing of the national anthem. In fact, it was discovered in 2015 that the Department of Justice spent millions of taxpayer dollars on what they called paid patriotism before major sporting events, but most notably, NFL events. So why football? Literally everywhere else in the world, football is the sport we know as soccer. And American football is, well, American. And although it is baseball that holds the title, football is truly America's game. Football was an escape for a lot of us. When you put the jersey of your favorite player on, join the crowd at the local bar, or tailgate with friends at the stadium, you were not a Democrat or Republican. You were not black or white. You were an Eagle, a Packer, a Raider, a Steeler. And while the lyrics of the Star Spangled Banner sang out, you were an American. For at least 3 hours, you escaped the chair on your team, ignoring whatever turmoil that may be around you. You didn't have to talk about your views on politics, but that was all about the change.
That needs to change. That's something that, you know, this country stands for: freedom, liberty, justice for all. And it's not happening for all right now.
Is this the first year that you haven't stood up? Did you do it other years, or is this the first time?
This year is the first year that I've done this.
So why did Kaepernick choose now to take this stance?
He took a knee right behind hundreds of service members being honored on Military Appreciation Night.
Well, There was a fire brewing in America in the summer of 2016.
In Rochester, New York, as a line of police advanced, demonstrators sat in the street in a show of civil disobedience.
A fire that the left-wing media prodded and poked at. A fire that Republican frontrunner Donald Trump poured gasoline on.
I mean, I've seen them marching down the street, essentially calling death to the police.
In a movement whose mission statement was echoed by Colin Kaepernick in that post-game interview.
There's a lot of things.
And although not mentioning them by name,
one specifically is police brutality. There's people being murdered unjustly.
It was very clear that he was influenced by Black Lives Matter
for killing people.
Now, Black Lives Matter started 3 years prior, gaining traction by protesting the many police killings over the years. And in July of 2016, after the murders of Alton Sterling and Philando Castile, happening literally one day from each other, Black Lives Matter led a protest in Dallas, Texas, which ended in the ambush killing of 5 officers. And although the murderer, Mika Johnson, had no affiliation with Black Lives Matter, the group was blamed for creating a culture that incited violence against police. This, with several Donald Trump rallies turning violent, as well as an uptick in white supremacist groups to counter Black Lives Matter. Racial tensions in America were so high that in the summer of 2016, several countries issued warnings to their citizens traveling to the U.S. to be aware, be safe, and comply with police. This was truly getting out of hand. Now, Kaepernick wouldn't be the first athlete to speak out about this issue. In July, LeBron James, Carmelo Anthony, Chris Paul, and Dwayne Wade opened the 2016 ESPY Awards with a Black Lives Matter message. But that was the NBA, so when Kaepernick sat down at a football game a month later, he now involved the NFL, America's game, and there was no turning back.
I don't mean no disrespect to anybody, but, you know, I'm just standing behind what I believe in.
Sheriff's deputies in Broward County urging its members not to provide escorts for Miami Dolphins players anymore, since 4 of whom have joined 10 other NFL players in a silent, peaceful protest.
And they say it's not the time to do this. Well, when is the time? It's never the time in somebody else's eyes.
Maybe he should find a country that works better for him. Let him try. It won't happen.
You know, my father was a World War II veteran, so when I see somebody like Colin Kaepernick in an NFL uniform, on an NFL field, not respect that flag.
A group of veterans is now getting behind Kaepernick. They're writing an open letter in favor of his right to, quote, silent protest.
Now, as far as actual football, the 2016 season wasn't particularly a great one for Cap. He started the season as a backup. He would get his first start in week 6 against the Buffalo Bills, a game in which they lost 16-45. In fact, the 49ers would go 2-14 that season, the worst regular season record in over a decade. And this was a fall from grace for Colin Kaepernick. In 2012, he was a superstar. He took over for Alex Smith mid-season after suffering a concussion. And although cleared to play shortly after, coach at the time, Jim Harbaugh, believed in Kaepernick and chose to stay with him over Alex Smith. The Niners now had a new face of the franchise. And in his first playoff game, he would break Michael Vick's quarterback rushing record, 181 yards against the Green Bay Packers. He led the 49ers all the way to Super Bowl 47. And although they lost by 3 points, he played well enough to be named the official starter for 2013. After going 12-4 that season, they would find themselves back in the NFC Championship game. It was one catch away from going to consecutive Super Bowls. Kaepernick would be given a 6-year contract extension worth $126 million. And the sky was the limit. But that 2014 season, after losing key players on defense, It was a test for Kaepernick and Coach Harbaugh. And despite the success, and being the first coach to take the team to a Super Bowl in over 20 years, reports from former and current players and members of the front office indicated that the organization was not too fond of Jim Harbaugh's hard-nosed coaching style.
Yeah, this guy's pretty hard to deal with. He has mad genius in him.
Yeah.
He has crazed rage to win in him.
The Niners finished 2014 8-8, missing the playoffs. And Harbaugh parted ways with the organization. The man who had drafted, mentored, and groomed Colin Kaepernick was now out of the league. It was the end of the Harbaugh era for San Francisco, and the beginning of the end of the Kaepernick era. And while struggling in the 2015 season, Kaepernick had ended his short tenure as the starting quarterback after being benched in week 9. So as he took a knee on that sideline in 2016, did he consider that maybe this is his last season, one way or the other? Because it was 2013 when George Zimmerman was found not guilty, which sparked the Black Lives Matter movement. He was in the Super Bowl. Where was the outrage then? When he was giving interviews to the Wall Street Journal about life and his endorsements, no mention of this at all. In 2014, with the murders of Mike Brown and Eric Garner, he was at the top of his game, the face of a franchise. Where was your t-shirt, Colin? So what was this protest really about? Is this about activism or holding on to fame? Or maybe when he took that knee, he knew that his time was running out, that his 15 minutes of fame in the NFL was just about up, and something had to be done to regain that spotlight.
And now the quarterback sparking new controversy for wearing these socks showing police officers as pigs. Those
it lessens any legitimacy to any point you're trying to make. You just want attention. You're not really serious about this. That's trolling.
Once, but if it feels strongly, go out and speak. Go out and be an advocate. Have something to say. Go talk to the community. This stupid symbolic gesture, it's offensive.
But Kaep would answer those critics.
Kaepernick says he's willing to make real change and plans on donating $1 million to charities that he's been working with to help end racial inequality.
So rather you believe he found enlightenment during the summer of 2016, or if you believe he was doing this for attention and to grab headlines, the impact that it had is undeniable. Coach Chip Kelly and general manager Trent Baalke were fired at the end of the 2016 season. Shortly after, Kaepernick opted out of his contract with the 49ers. He thought this was ending his relationship with the organization. But what he didn't know was that it was ending his career with the NFL.
Great American values. We're proud of our country. We respect our flag. Wouldn't you love to see one of these NFL owners, when somebody disrespects our flag, to say, get that son of a bitch off the field right now, out, he's fired. He's fired!
Overall this year, NFL ratings are down 13%, which for the NFL translates to tens of millions of lost dollars.
2017 was here, and the NFL was still riddled in controversy. And by kickoff, after free agency, the draft, training camp, not a single one of the 32 NFL teams would have Colin Kaepernick on their roster. This sparked an NFL boycott, a blackout.
I'm about to become a college football fan only, watch a little high school football, but if Kaepernick can't get a job and I see that Jay Cutler can, that tells me that, you know, something is wrong with the system.
I'm not going to watch it, though. My conscience is not going to allow me to watch it.
A boycott against the league for not signing Kaepernick, to go along with the other boycott against the players' protests that was now refueled by President Donald Trump.
Palmetto Restaurant and Ale House now changing the channel during NFL football games after recent protests during the national anthem.
Putting the NFL in a very odd situation. And with Kaepernick out of the league, a new face of the movement emerged. Philadelphia Eagles safety Malcolm Jenkins joined alongside former player and former Kaepernick teammate Anquan Boldin to create a players' coalition.
Philadelphia Eagles safety Malcolm Jenkins, he has raised a fist in protest during the national anthem. He's also among a group of players who has asked the NFL to devote a month to awareness on social issues.
And with the league in such a compromised position, losing millions week in and week out, being boycotted from two opposing sides, the coalition was able to get a sit down with the bosses, the owners themselves. And one of the items on the table was what to do about Kaepernick, figuring out a way to squash the beef finally between him and the NFL. In October, a meeting was scheduled. Now here's where the facts get a little sketchy. According to the coalition, Kaepernick was invited to the sit down. He failed to cooperate, failed to show.
Is there a reason why Colin Kaepernick was invited to this meeting?
I think everybody... I don't know the reason that. He was invited, actually.
He was invited?
He was invited.
Okay, why didn't he come?
How do you think about not being invited?
That's a good question. I don't know. I can't say.
But according to Kaepernick's lawyer, they were shunned. Shut out from the start.
We specifically reached out to the NFL Players Association and to the Players Coalition, the group led by Jenkins, and we were verbatim told that Colin had no role.
No role in a movement he started? Colin and his lawyer would file a grievance against the NFL for colluding to keep him out of the league. It made sense because as key quarterbacks would get injured, Kaepernick wasn't even a part of the conversation.
Kaepernick's lawyer claims multiple NFL head coaches stated that they wanted to sign Mr. Kaepernick, only to mysteriously go silent. The owners are being asked to hand over cell phone records and emails. They were chosen based on their public statements about either Kaepernick or the player protests during the national anthem.
I just don't know how you prove this. We all believe it, Skip. You just filed a lawsuit against them. What's the likelihood at any point in time in 2018, 19, or moving forward?
That's why it's a last desperate act, because whatever bridge was left, I think you just burned it to the ground.
But Kaepernick was in a bit of a catch-22. According to sources, the owners threatened to cancel the meeting if Colin was involved, because it was clear that he would not stop the protests if he was to return. But how could he at this point? How serious could we take him if he was to do that? Muhammad Ali didn't crawl back to boxing, promising to change his name back to Cassius Clay and cut all ties with the Nation of Islam. Cap had to stand his ground. So with Kaepernick blackballed out of the league, the Players Coalition continued to protest, and TV ratings continued to fall.
Average ratings for the first 5 weeks of the 2017 season are just over 15 million viewers. That's a 7% drop in the same period last season, and a more worrying 18% drop from the more than 18 million viewers in 2015.
Pictures of empty stadiums circulated the web. Reports surfaced that the NFL owners would reach an agreement with the coalition to donate up to $100 million to their causes. The owners had to stop the bleeding. So in December, Malcolm Jenkins had announced that he would no longer be raising his fist and ending his protests. At the same exact time, the NFL had agreed to give $89 million to the coalition's cause.
Well, this is interesting for Malcolm Jenkins because he's starting to look a little funny in the light, I think, to some people. And I don't know what exactly is going on, but I talked to one player in the coalition and his response was, someone's lying. The fact that he doesn't know who the person is that's lying isn't a good look for people, especially after Eric Reed did the interview with Slate, where he said that someone from the league had talked to him and asked if this agreement was done, would he stop protesting? And then magically Malcolm Jenkins turns up that same day and says he will no longer raise his fist. I don't think that's a good look for anybody involved in this.
Now, Malcolm Jenkins didn't order any other players to end their protests. But with him being the leader of the Players Coalition, and with them striking the deal with the owners, it was pretty much a cease and desist order. So did they take the hush money? Did they sell Colin Kaepernick's movement from up under him? Or is this what Kaepernick's sacrifice was for all along? A solution. In my opinion, this was the league telling Colin Kaepernick, I see your $1 million donation, and I raise you $89 million. I see you and Eric Reed's take a knee protest, and I raise you an NFL Players Coalition, a hijacking and dismantling of your protest. Oh, and by the way, you will never play football in this country again. Well, at least not in the NFL. Hey, I hear the XFL's making a comeback. Maybe you can play there. You can be the new He Hate Me, or They Hate Me in this case. In my opinion, the best comparison to Colin Kaepernick's plight isn't of Muhammad Ali. Now, most people are familiar with this image and what it represents. But a lot of us in our generation do not know the names of Tommy Smith and John Carlos, who raised their fists during the playing of the national anthem in the 1968 Olympics, protesting injustices happening in the U.S. They were stripped of their medals, expelled from the U.S. track team, and banned from the Olympic Games. And unlike Muhammad Ali, there was no second chance. This was the sacrifice they made to bring awareness on an international level. So when people have forgotten all about these protests in the summer of 2016, well, we still remember this image. Because in August, as we are kicking off the 2018 season, over 90 quarterbacks will make an NFL roster, and Colin Kaepernick will not be one of them. So as we go through another summer and prepare for another year of football, business as usual, how will history write Colin Kaepernick? Well, that's completely up to you. Thank you for watching. Subscribe. Goodbye.